Welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect Andromeda Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari, the RPG chick. Headed to finally activate one of Elaaden's monoliths. Oh, I didn't realize it would even give a quest marker. Okay. It's to the left. Somewhere.
Temperature levels are climbing, Pathfinder.
Over here, of course they are. That must be it.
Environment check. Temperatures are within acceptable parameters.
Yeah, I spoke too soon again.
Pathfinder, I detect a dip in temperature ahead. The scavengers have set a dune camp.
Well, we're gonna unset it. Fortunately, we haven't got any chips. Not chips. Yeah, bypass chips? Whatever the hell they're called. We've got a whole bunch of consoles. We need to activate all these consoles? You like that, huh? What'd that do? Okay. So we need to get to the top of all these. Somehow. Or at least be able to see them, right? Okay. I didn't think we could make that, but we did. So we can see all the glyphs from here? Or two of them. Synaptic glyph. Built in a form that resembles an organic being's nervous system or megaparsec wide galactic filaments, several data clusters in this glyph are marked as crucially important. Word fragments recovered include somatic and possibly solipsistic. Semiosis glyph. This glyph contains a massive quantity of sensation-inducing data, visual, oral, tactile, infrasound, with accompanying signs, but it's difficult to interpret without additional cultural clues. The tone appears to be one of reassurance, teaching, or historical record. So we're just missing... Oh, we can see that one. Cool. Just move a little this way, excuse me. Oh, I felt like I wanted to zoom in there. Damn it. Maybe if I jump to this one. From here, jump there. Can we see it from here? Still too far away. Alright. Oh, I just barely made that, didn't I? Gotcha! Zero glyph. The material and conductive data in this glyph match our own readings for the functions of element zero, but at a much higher level of fluency. Possible work fragments recovered include foundation and abundance. Okay. Well, let's see how tough this is.
Nice.
I didn't have to do anything? I can't see the beam, though. Where's the beam? I hear things. It says I activated it. 1 out of 3. Alright. That was easy. I didn't have to solve the thing, the puzzle. Oh, we got some over here. Some cadmium. Thank you. Next monolith. There's one of them here. What? I hope they're all like that. That was awesome. I had red at 4s or at the other one? That's the other one.
Saw some of your scouts.
Dead, probably. Otherwise, you wouldn't have.
This is it. Honey, I'm home. This is probably the back way. Okay, so we've got one extra console. Notice there's nothing here to fight, at least so far. Okie-dokie. Verdurous glyph. Verdurous glyph? The data in this glyph is structured via a root, stem, leaf... excuse me, Drac. Organizational mode. It could be describing a philosophical argument taken to many conclusions, or an ecosystem laid out from bacteria to higher animals. It could be many things. Oh, we've got a... What's this? I've never seen in quite that color. Oh, it changes color? Okay, so we got one over there and one there. Is it... This, I've seen this one, right? Verdurous. I need to get over to the other one. I don't think I can, unless I can travel on this thing. Nope. Whee! So how do I get up on this one? Uh-huh. Unless there's a... another console that I missed. Nihility glyph. At first analysis, this glyph contains a scant amount of information, but the organizational structure suggests the data is actually describing negative space. The accompanying data is analogous to music that contains long intervals. Yeah, whatever you say. And where's the other one go? Oh! Here, I thought this was the one we saw already.
You should magnitude. Now be able to interface Pathfinder.
Correct. Magnitude glyph. This glyph's data contains a mathematical structure for easily describing immense measurements of volume, time, and distance. It appears whoever designed these glyphs expected to use such structures frequently. Ugh.
All right. Got it.
Again, no puzzles. I just have to wonder, where's the beam? Well, we have to activate them all to get the beam? I'm used to this beam coming out of them. Okay. Well, I could just fast travel right to the next one. Which is... Wait, no. Where am I? I am here. That I know. Have I been to the other one? Where's the third? Why can't... I'm probably looking right at it. Oh, you know, 'cause I've... Where are they? I could have sworn I just... I could have sworn I just pointed at them, all of them. Oh, it's over here. Well, we might as well go here and place the receiver. That shouldn't take that long. That's the closest spot anyway. It's mostly it takes a while to figure out how to get up to where we want to go. Oh, look at those guns! Really got these guns?
Temperature levels are climbing, Pathfinder.
Oh, I can't scan them. That's disappointing.
Environmental temperatures are within acceptable limits.
Did I check this one? Where's the loadout research center? This one doesn't have a terminal? No terminal. Huh. Alright. So to get up there, probably be challenging. Maybe I can go up this way. So about face. Now pardon me while I destroy everything. I just have to put all this stuff in the way like this, Jesus.
I don't think we'll last much longer in this.
We're fine. Can't really go on that, can we? I was trying to get in there. That's what I was trying to do. Maybe we can. All right.
BB, you're sure you're not half Krogan?
Nope. Why?
Half
your
Krogan.
Attitude, aggression, the way you don't take shit from anyone.
My mother made it exclusively with other Asari.
Is that right?
Alright, we need to be trying to get up here.
Except when she conceived me. My father was an Elcor.
You've got to be kidding.
She is kidding.
Offended indignation. Why? Doesn't it fit?
You're as far from an Elcor as I can imagine.
Mm-hmm. Then it makes perfect sense, right?
I suppose so. You little rebel.
I don't believe that. Sorry. Well, there's the beam, I guess. Is someone shooting at us? Hey. Get out before the thing... Look, it's fixing itself. This thing's alive. Oh, I'm free falling there. Tom Petty. Free fall. Alright. I miss Tom Petty. Place the receiver. Ta-da!
Helios News Service, now broadcasting live.
Sweet. And again, we can't climb the ladder, right? A ladder you can't climb? That's no fair. You only hear the noise if you look up. Oh yeah. Nexus News Signal. Console used to control various operations. In this case, one operation.
A bar opens on the Nexus. Visitors herald the vortex as a sign of civility, and the opposite of civility, as more sleepers wake.
That show was HNS. Alright, let's go there. Try not to piss off worm thing. What's that? Oh, that's where the architect is. That's why I'm trying to do this, and then see if we can have the vault open up. The remnant vault, so we can, you know, make it easier to... Oh, that, there is that thing. Let's get out and save. Just in case we die horribly. Now, there's no shade here. Seems like there should be. Well, I can see the monolith, that's a good thing. Jumping in midair!
Never met someone who wore so much dead stuff.
Yeah, you have. Just That's not big. Dead on the outside.
Nah. Yeah, huh? Dead on the outside. I don't want to fight that. I really don't. I'll probably die before we can do much against it. I see it! Just stay over there, it's okay. Just go any other way. It's coming back. I don't really want to face that thing. Oh. Okay. Safe condition. Sweet.
Life support restored.
Is there anything I have to do here? Did I raise anything up? Other consoles? Anything like that? That thing better not come in here and start attacking. Don't do... Oh my god. Don't do that. I can't stand Drax sometimes. I really can't. Supposed to be getting up here this way? I guess not. Well, let's... I hear that thing. I really don't want to be messing with that. Scan for glyphs, it says. Look! Good god. Is this thing gonna come down here? Make this dust bowl livable. Haha, I like that. Oops. Oh. Cadmium. I love you, Cadmium. You're not a giant worm thing that will attack me. Well, we can get to this one. Two, right there. Good god. Accretion glyph. This glyph's data has a spiral structure. The file's organized to describe either a... definitive scientific conclusion or a model showing the formation of various interstellar bodies. However, the spiral can be read in either direction. Where is it now? Hydrodynamic glyph. This glyph appears to contain... Oh, there's weird monsters over there. Oh, well, well, well. But this appears to contain data on fluid dynamics, but this may also be an analogy for power or information flow. Some of its data translates as physical sensations, specifically the sense of weightlessness caused by the immersion underwater or zero gravity. What was the other one? On that. Oops. Oh, it's just... okay. It's on this little thing. This one's been buried. Yeah, baby, get in places. Glyph time.
You should now be able to interface, Pathfinder.
God. Like, I don't know that by now. Stratospheric glyph. The data of this glyph appears to be devoted to atmospheric conditions, seasonal temperature variations, and high-altitude bacterial life. Some appears to be up-to-date, the rest appears to be predictive. Okay, then. Let's do the do. Ah! We got a puzzle. Use one remnant decryption key? How many glyphs do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. When there's 5 possible glyphs like this? I thought I only had one before. I'm gonna override it.
That did it!
What? Where are they going? Oh, wait. Okay, now what? Question mark. I don't want to be messing around here much longer. Okay. Investigate the vault's entrance. Good. Alright. We did all three, wow. That's the quickest ever. Is it? This way? I wish I could turn off that wheel thing, because I always think I'm headed towards...
Something with more heft.
I like to be light on my feet.
But you got biotics. You can make me light on my feet.
You're dangerous enough as it is, old man.
Ain't that the truth? That's loud. Now before I, well, I guess I'm going to sign off this episode. Before I do though, some light reading. I got some stuff in Codex here that I like to keep on top of it ever since we caught up. The journey so far for exploring Helios. The Krogan Exiles. By giving the remnant drive core to Morda and the Krogan colony, see last episode, you convinced them to rejoin the initiative. We have an outpost on Elaaden, thanks to your bold choice. Now the funny thing is, I didn't think we could even put an outpost until we did the vault. Right? All the monoliths in the vault? I thought we couldn't settle until then, but man, this one, we can. And planets and locations. Elaaden is the only one, right? Yeah. Elaaden is, I don't know what's new or old, so I'm just going to read it all, but anyone wants to tune out now, they can, because I'm going to end the episode after this. But anyway, Elaaden is a scorching desert moon of a gas giant. Identified on initiative charts as Habitat 2, Elaaden was considered a golden world, despite its harsh conditions because of the moon's vast mineral wealth. Tidal gravitational effects cause plumes of sodium silicate to erupt from Elaaden's core, depositing unusually pure silicon sand across the surface, invaluable for manufacturing high-performance computer hardware. Well, I don't think they'll ever run out of that stuff. Orbital surveys show that contrary to projections, Elaaden is almost devoid of water vapor, making long-term settlement or mining efforts unlikely. Those who live on Elaaden faced a constant struggle for survival. Able to thrive in environments that would kill most organic species in days, the Krogan who departed the Nexus have established a colony on Elaaden and defend their sovereignty fiercely. The Nexus advises travelers to avoid Elaaden if possible. After the gift of a valuable remnant drive core, the Krogan colony of New Tuchanka is now allied with the Initiative. Overlord Morda shares leadership with the Initiative's assigned representative, I forgot how to say it, Karist Arcana? Kariste Arcana? I don't know. The Nexus is gathering a negotiation team to draw up mineral and water claims on Elaaden. There is no data on whom the Krogan are choosing as negotiators. The Krogan are not very good negotiators. But I'm going to exit just to save. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode when we tackle the Elaaden Vault. Until then, endure. In enduring, grow strong.